Okay, so I'm about to paint a painting of my chart. It's on a large square canvas. Here's me. It's like 4 by 4 feet. And first thing I gotta do is put in my background colors, and that's what I'm gonna show you right now. Whoops. My background colors, this is retardant, which just makes the paint not dry as fast. My background colors are black and then some blues. Because what I'm going to be doing is, it's a square painting, I'm going to put my chart on it as a square. But in the middle, I'm going to show the galaxy as it was at the time of my chart. Actually put the planets all in the right places and show the Earth with the right continent tilted to the right place and draw a line for the ascendant. So I'm putting space from a tilted view in the middle of the canvas, like an oblong thing, a tilted view of the galaxy with all the planets. And my chart is also on the painting, so the two are going to blend together, run over each other a bit. But the background is black across the middle in a sort of spaceship saucer space, a saucer spaceship, like in black in the middle, and then one blue, halo cyanide blue, is going to go up and fade to black at the top. Ultramarine blue will go down below that black, and it will fade to a lighter blue, as if the sky on Earth. So we'll have black at the top, sky blue at the bottom, dark blue in between, top and bottom, and black in the middle. It's going to be a very interesting background. And so let's do that background. We're going to need a bit of paint, so I got out some bigger containers and a big brush. So black figure. Gonna need probably that much. And halo. Halo blue at the top. Gonna want that much. Ultramarine blue at the bottom, about the same amount as the halo, and then sky blue, not very much, it's just going across a smaller section of the bottom. The black I accounted for the top already, and I'm going to put a little bit of extender into the with the blues. I guess I'll put a little bit of the black. Because what do you need to be popped one time or something? Oh. Yeah, I wanna be able to I got a bit of it on the canvas there. Bloop. I wanna be able to smudge the borders a little more than you usually can with acrylics. So I'm adding a little life extender to the acrylic paint. Just done that. I've wiped it on my pants. It's great. Alright. So now I can just let them sit, except what I'll do is spray them with a little water to keep them surface flexible. Go get my water spray bottle. My water spray bottle is, like many things I own, entirely red. A brilliant, bright red. Enameled, in fact. So, acrylics are water-based, so keep their surface wet and then they won't dry out on you at all. Okay, so I don't need my tubes anymore. And basically I just need to paint these large areas on the canvas. So I'm going to move the camera. Okay, here we go. Now it's time to lay down the large areas of our painting. I'm going to have my chart in a little bit. That's just going to be blue right now though, so the black is going to be a thing here, and I have to figure how much, and I'm figuring that right now. I'm actually thinking here's the Earth and here's the Moon, and over there I put Sun and Mercury and Venus above the Earth, and over there's Mars, and Saturn and Jupiter are over here. Rahu and Ketu. So the black needs to be about that tall. So I'm going to mix my black up with its retardant. Is to go fast so that all the paints remain wet, and then you can smudge the edges together better. So I need the black to be about this tall, and I'm eyeballing the middle of the painting. I pretty much do a lot by eyeballing. These are the edges of the black galaxy. By the way, I've got a guitar case behind the painting holding the chair up, and then I've got a pin right here at the bottom holding the canvas so that it won't slide towards me, and I've got a board behind it so that it's well supported on the chair, not just by its own, you know, crossboards, but by something that touches those crossboards, all of them, and holds the canvas up really well. So, basically I've got a surface that I can wail away on. I can press hard and it's not going to go anywhere. Now, there's nothing wrong with extending the life of your acrylic paint by spraying it, getting it wet on the canvas. What's wrong with that? Nothing. So that makes it really easy then to spread around, because it was already starting to dry up on me. As long as you don't spray so much that you create runs. We don't want any runs. Black galaxy. What's wrong with asking for a nice black galaxy? Nothing. It existed before us, it will exist after us. We can discuss it all we want, but it's greater than us, so. So that's that. Okay, I like that right there the best. So going with that as my medium. I am making sure I'm there.
everywhere else. This needs to be a little fatter. So does this. Okay. We don't have to get it perfect right now. And just to keep the edges of that wet, but without causing any runs, just a light bit of water. Okay, I've still got some black and I've still got the top. And that's just really kind of a stripe that's gonna quickly go into dark blue. You can see that I'm using quite a bit of pressure, and painting is taking it like a Roman fortress because of what I said earlier. I'm getting all the remainder out of here, you know, because I was raised Irish, you're supposed to use up everything. So I've got quite a bit more black here, so I'm going to use that to do merge edge. I'm just blopping it on so I can merge it with the blue. My pen just gave way, which means the painting tries to move forward to me and spill my stuff on the ground. But I'm not going to let it. I'm going to back it up again and make it respect my pen. By driving it in here. Using a tool, something humans do. And thus breaking the pin and rendering it useless, needing thus that I go get another one, unless the staff of the pin holds it, which it seems to be for now. I'll trust that for now, and I'll watch for flying blue. Okay. So now we're going with halo cyanide blue, mixing it with its retardant, making the mistake of not first cleaning our black brush. So I'm doing that now, except that's really good for the merge area. So let's just use that along the merge area, because it's black and halo. That's exactly what we're going to do there. And then let's go clean our black brush, so that it's not a black brush. I'll be right back. This is a pause in the video. Then. mix my halo with its retardant, which I squirted in there. This is my favorite paint, this color of blue. And we want it to be really pure in this area, all the way down to the black. So get that done first. It's going to meet the other. This is, I've never used retardant, but it heavily affects the paint. I can see that. Makes it much thinner. Even though I didn't put very much, I thought I put very little, but it made the paint much thinner, and that is bugging me because I'm not able to like get solid halo here. So I'm gonna have to get the tube out, and I'm already out anyway. I mean, I could go with this and merge it with the black and then fill it in later, or do it now. I tend to go over things twice anyway. I'll probably end up doing it later. So if I bring this up here now, let's see what I can do with this. Get out tube halo. And I'm putting it straight on the brush, and you can see it's quite a bit darker than what I had going on. Again, that black is having dry time, so I'm just giving it incentive not to. So I still want to merge it nicely. So now I've got enough paint across the top, but since I'm here, I'm going to increase the bottom, except there's black on my brush, so that's got to come off. So this is okay for merge top, but I gotta go clean my brush again and get this black stripe off of here right now. just because it's in the halo area. That's all. That's the only reason. There. Now I just gotta halo that again. After I clean my brush again. So now, quickly, with pure halo, no black, fix our center. Careful not to touch black above it. I've got blue water dripping down because of my washing of my brush. I just have to watch out for that. Mainly for my floor or whatever. I should actually have something underneath me. I should always, because painting is a messy business. And your house matters, and your spouse will like you more if you don't paint every floor in the house with your paint droppings. Halo from the tube along the line. This line may change in the future. I mean, with me, the painting can so change, you know. I repaint paintings a bunch of times. Before they're done, I've usually gone over them. 4 or 5 times, at least. I keep putting a little more halo on the brush because I just really want that color to be very, very, very rich on this painting in this area. Any show through of, you know, just for the heck of it, of white canvas. I really want this lapis lazuli like blue to be really strong because it's actually representing the dark night sky, and that is a dark, dark blue. The dark night sky is a dark, dark blue. Now I'm getting close to the merge point. Because I can always go over this after it's dry and add a little, just another little layer, and it'll be total. Because there's only a little bit of canvas shown at this point. Kind of like the idea of having it arch with the galaxy, the brush strokes, that is. So I'm sort of arching my brush strokes in alignment with the galaxy's edge, wherever I am. If I'm over here, then I'm aligned with over here. I have to go across, flat, and as I go down, I'm going down. I think that'll add a nice touch. I think people see everything. I see over there. All right, so now I don't always cap my paints right away. Does that make me a bad person? So now we start to merge, which is a very careful process because you want to stay right in that area only. Be very careful about wrongly moving like too much black into the blue, too much blue into the black. Okay, now my brush is clean again, so I'm ready to do the blue merge portion. And I'm just taking a good eyeball of what I've got going on. And I can see that I've got some black across the middle, so I'm going to come from the sides of that and try to, actually right now I'm going to try to minimize that up into the middle all by itself. Okay, then wipe off my brush so that I don't spread more of that black that I just touched. And start with the halo area. Get my brush inundated in pure halo and work my way up then. And once I'm into the black sufficiently, I'm actually done. Is now. That's it. Okay, now I wipe off my brush again. Instead of washing, I'm just going to wipe, which is about as good, almost as good. Since I'm going to a very similar color set, it's okay with me. You got to wash it good, by the way. These big, thick brushes, they need a lot of love to get the paint out of them. Because they got a lot of bristles in there. Saying, me next. Okay. So now it is time for ultramarine blue, which goes below the black. As you can see, it's a little different. Give me that other blue at the bottom. Maybe this is just enough. And maybe I put just enough on, maybe I have just the right amount to get the bottom here aquamarine blue as opposed to the top, which is halocyanite. And I'm taking the blue from wherever I can to try to make this line more complete. Good old twist your brush technique. Kind of have this rolling perfect edge you can watch with your eyes and know that you're, you know, not violating the edge. Makes for interesting texture too. I start with the, kind of like parallel to the oblongness of my black galaxy, my strokes. I'm sensing that I could use a wee bit more water because it's starting to dry out on me, and I don't want that quite yet. Water is the answer. Now this looks like an island made of coal out in the middle of the ocean, doesn't it? Or it could be a black hole getting really close to Earth. It could be any number of things, Watson. It would be a bad time to judge. It's got some black on my brush, so I'm being careful to get it off. I am putting back on my brush, the last remaining portion I have of that paint, to cover up the bad breath of that black. And I'm continuing to finish my coverage of ultramarine blue on this lower portion of the canvas. I wonder if whirling clouds would look cool. Or that spin the brush texture everywhere. That would look cool. Just on the lower portion. Maybe like just a few of them. Like clouds in the sky. Before we get down to the blue sky, there's clouds in the upper sky, underneath the galaxy. Clouds of different sizes and shapes. Clouds that love you and make you love them. Clouds that merge to the edge with a deeper halo, and then he cleans his brush. Clouds that spin along the edge and say, we exist, so do you. This is nice. I like texturing the bottom. I like that idea. It makes for some interesting black lighting for possibilities as well. Could really make some interesting things out of all these shapes that it's producing. This is called spontaneous thinking. I did not have this planned, but I like the effect, so I'm going with it. That's it. Maybe this is an example of out of the box. We're just normal artists. My hands are getting tired. But I won't stop. You'll see. Aries rising with Saturn in the ninth with Jupiter. It's like he's into now, but as well he's into like endurance. It's kind of a rare combo. I don't want any part to be too much the same. Like, there's got to be difference everywhere. Broken up, no unifying pattern. Just a hell of a lot of swirls. Now, that is good enough. We'll proceed to that bottom color, which is right here, which I am just going to put across the bottom, as I've promised. And I have a piece of paper guarding Grandma's chair because I care about Grandma's chair. I don't want it being painted by me. It has its original look, and that's how it's going to stay. Well, it's in my care. There. There's a little bit of blue missing, but I can fill that in. That's what I wanted. There, that's what I wanted. I got exactly what I wanted. I got exactly. Okay. Whatever you say, buddy.
Oh, you're still recording, right?
Yeah. So I got exactly what I wanted. I got black, dark blue, the galaxy, and then more towards Earth, a dark blue, but it's getting lighter, and then sky blue. So I got what I wanted. Short amount of time. Perfect. Let it dry, and then I can continue. And what I always do with anything extra is I paint the borders. I mean the edges of the canvas. If there's anything left in these bowls, oh, there is. And in fact, there's enough of that blue paint to finish it off. I didn't know that. Well, let's do that then. As well have a good solid bottom, like a good rock song has to have a good solid bottom. Now that doesn't mean derriere. No, not the derriere in Derry, Ireland, and not the derriere found on every person in the area known as their rump. No. Everything must have a good tear. Actually, the bottom on a rock song, I did mean the rump. You know, you gotta have a good bottom. I'm funny. No, I'm not. Oh wow, this is starting to mess up. So I'll have to get out more of that paint and fix it up when it dries. Stronger strokes seem to work with it at this point. Again, I'm not used to that retardant stuff. It totally changes the nature of the paint. It's weird. I don't like it. Although I kind of do. It's weird. It's acting like enamel. It's like teasing me with becoming sticky and bundling up into little bits, but at the same time it's still flowing. That's enamel for you. And it's different in each direction, and brush strokes start and ends matter to the max. Like that brush stroke start right there is so hard to get it light. Now you have to get it light and then immediately hard. Light and then immediately hard to smear it in. Light and then immediately hard. That's the best I can do with that. And that looks good. And I think I'll do a little bit of light and then immediately hard right across here. That's not working out. Just trying to make even on both sides. I'll have to fix it up, but yeah, the black went too far over here. This light is what is known as intermittent. You should see the copper wire I have on it to try to hold it together. It's funny. Yeah, I'm looking in you. I'm looking in your viewer, and what I see is what I want. That's nice. Okay. Enough for now. Break time. Now it's time to lay down the large areas of our painting. I'm going to have my chart in a little bit. That's just going to be blue right now, though. So the black is going to be a thing here, and I have to figure how much. And I'm figuring that right now. Actually thinking here's the Earth and here's the Moon, and over there I put Sun and Mercury and Venus above the Earth, and over there's Mars, and Saturn and Jupiter are over here. Bottom and K2, so black needs to be about that tall. So I'm going to mix my black up with its retardant.
idea is to go fast so that all the paints remain wet, and then you can smudge the edges together better. So I need the black to be about this tall. And I'm eyeballing the middle of the painting. I pretty much do a lot by eyeball. These are the edges of the black galaxy. By the way, I've got a guitar case behind the painting, holding the chair up, and then I've got a pin right here at the bottom, holding the canvas so that it won't slide towards me. And I've got a board behind it so that it's well supported on the chair, not just by its own, you know, crossboards, but by something that touches those crossboards, all of them, and holds the canvas up really well. So, basically I've got a surface that I can wail away on. I can press hard and it's not going to go anywhere. Now, there's nothing wrong with extending the life of your acrylic paint by spraying it. Getting it wet on the canvas. What's wrong with that? Nothing. So that makes it really easy then to spread around, because it was already starting to dry up on it. As long as you don't spray so much that you create runs. We don't want any runs. Want a nice black galaxy. What, you know, what's wrong with asking for a nice black galaxy? Nothing. It existed before us, it will exist after us. We can discuss it all we want, but it's greater than us, so that's that. Okay, I like that right there the best. So going with that as my medium. And making sure I'm there everywhere else. This needs to be a little fatter. So does this. We don't have to get it perfect right now. Okay. And just to keep the edges of that wet, but without causing any runs, just a light bit of water. Okay. I've still got some black and I've still got the top. And that's just really kind of a stripe that's going to quickly go into dark blue. see that I'm using quite a bit of pressure, and painting is taking it like a Roman fortress because of what I said earlier. I'm getting all the remainder out of here, you know, because I was raised Irish, you're supposed to use up everything, so I've got quite a bit more black here, so I'm going to use that to do merge edge paint. I'm just blopping it on so I can merge it with the blue. My pen just gave way, which means the painting tries to move forward to me and spill my stuff on the ground, but I'm not going to let it. I'm going to back it up again and make it respect my pen. By driving it in here. Like by using a tool, something humans do. Breaking the pin and rendering it useless, meaning thus that I go get another one, unless the staff of the pin holds it, which it seems to be for now. I'll trust that for now, and I'll watch for flying blue. Okay, so now we're going with halo cyanide blue, mixing it with its retardant, making a mistake of not first cleaning our black brush. So I'm doing that now, except that's really good for the merge area. So let's just use that along the merge area. Because it's black and halo, that's exactly what we're going to do there. And then let's go clean our black brush so that it's not a black brush. I'll be right back. This is a pause in the video. Mix my halo with its retardant, which I squirted in there. This is my favorite paint, this color of blue. And we want it to be really pure in this area, all the way down to the black. So get that done first. Going to meet the other. Thank you. this is, I've never used retardant, but it heavily affects the paint. I can see that. Makes it much thinner. Even though I didn't put very much, I thought I put very little, but it made the paint much thinner, and that is bugging me because I'm not able to like get solid halo here. So I'm gonna have to get the tube out, and I'm already out anyway. I mean, I could go with this and merge it with the black and then fill it in later, or do it now. I tend to go over things twice anyway. I'll probably end up doing it later. So if I bring this up here now, let's see what I can do with this. How's our pin doing down there? It must have touched some black there, so that causes a problem. So I'm going to get out tube halo. Putting it straight on the brush, and you can see it's quite a bit darker than what I had going on. Again, that black is having dry time, so I'm just giving it incentive not to. So I still want to merge it nicely. So now I've got enough paint across the top, but since I'm here, I'm going to increase the bottom, except there's black on my brush, so that's got to come off. This is okay for merge top, but I gotta go clean my brush again and get this black stripe off of here right now. Just because it's in the halo area. That's all. That's the only reason. There. Now I just gotta halo that again. After I clean my brush again. So now, quickly, with pure halo, no black, fix our center. Careful not to touch black above it. I've got blue water dripping down because of my washing of my brush. I just have to watch out for that. Maybe for my floor or whatever. Should actually have something underneath me. You should always, because painting is a messy business. And your house matters, and your spouse will like you more if you don't paint every floor in the house with your paint droppings. from the tube along the line. This line may change in the future. I mean, with me, the painting can so change, you know. I repaint paintings a bunch of times. Before they're done, I've usually gone over them 4 or 5 times, at least. I keep putting a little more halo on the brush because I just really want that color to be very, very, very rich on this painting in this area. I don't want any show through of, you know, just for the heck of it, of white canvas. I really want this lapis lazuli like blue to be really strong, because it's actually representing. Okay, now my brush is clean again, so I'm ready to do the blue merge portion. And I'm just taking a good eyeball of what I've got going on. And I can see that I've got some black across the middle, so I'm going to come from the sides of that and try to, except right now I'm going to try to minimize that up into the middle all by itself. Okay, then wipe off my brush so that I don't spread more of that black that I just touched. And start with the halo area. Get my brush inundated in pure halo and work my way up then. And once I'm into the black sufficiently, I'm actually done. Now. That's it. Okay, now I wipe off my brush again. Instead of washing, I'm just going to wipe, which is about as good. Almost as good. Since I'm going to a very similar color set, it's okay with me. You got to wash it good, by the way. These big, thick brushes, they need a lot of love to get the paint out of them. Because they got a lot of bristles in there. Saying, me next. Okay. So now it is time for ultramarine blue, which goes below the black. As you can see, it's a little different. See. And that other blue at the bottom. And maybe I put just enough on. Maybe I have just the right amount to get the bottom here aquamarine blue as opposed to the top, which is halocyanide. And taking the blue from wherever I can to try to make this line more complete. There, that's what I wanted. I got exactly what I wanted.